Hi friends, today in this session we are going to discuss about the topic database design. We have already gone through many topics in the DBMS, so don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and please go through the DBMS playlist if you hadn't. And today we are going to discuss about database design. Database design is nothing but a kind of data modeling in which we represent data in a specific way so that the end users as well as the developers can make it happen easily to manage the data as well as to retrieve the data. So database design is divided into certain steps like requirement analysis, database design implementation, and further levels are also there in database design, but briefly we are going to discuss about these three levels. So requirement analysis is nothing but planning and system definition, and database design is nothing but logical or physical model, and implementation is nothing but data conversion and loading and next testing. So what are all these and why these are subdivided into all of this, and what are these techniques? Let's see. So let's start with the definition of the database design. Database design is a collection of processes that facilitates the designing, development and implementation and maintenance of the enterprise data management and system. So what this data design helps us to show that designing, development and implementation and maintenance. So for this data management system, for performing operations we have certain techniques like structure of the data and data modeling as well. For overall designing on the database based on their index values, based on their primary keys, these designing has to be occurred and these implementations has to be used. The for which data, which kind of implementation has to be used, this can be clarified by this database design. So properly designed database are easy to maintain, improves data consistency and are cost effective in terms of disk storage space. So these databases designs are very easy to manage and they are very consistent and cost effective as well, as in the terms of the disk storage space. As we have already seen, in this disk storage space we have four terms like data, dictionaries and statistical data, indices as well, and some of other. For this, there is a in comparison to that, these database design will help us in maintaining our data consistency as well as the cost as well. And database design decides how our data elements correlate and what the data must be stored. So it tells what kind of data has to be stored, and it also tells how they are correlated and how they are engaged with each other. One data is related to the other data. All of kind of this information can be enabled by this database designer. And the main objective of database design in DBMS are to produce logical and physical designs models of the proposed database design. What are these logical and physical design? Logical and physical design are nothing but the perspective of the structural view as well as the internal conceptual view can be easily modified, can be designed by this database design. How is it possible? Let's see in the further classes. The logical model concentrates on the data requirements and the data to be stored independent of physical considerations. What is this term related? Logical in the sense conceptual data. How this conceptual data can be required or retrieved, or how it can be stored so that the physical data can be easily modified or can be independent. How is it possible can always already seen by this database designer. It doesn't concern itself with how the data will be stored and where it will be stored physically. So this database design won't make sure or concerns or as well as it won't take care of how the data is stored in the physical manner. And if I store data in this format, will it affect the outer storage? It won't go through all of these kind of things. It just implements the data in the form of a data model physically. And then the physical database design model involves translating the logical database design of the database onto the physical media using hardware resources and software systems such as database management system. So these physical logic data design model involves translating the logical database design to the database. This conceptual database is implemented to a database, and these database which is converted into the logical view is again converted into the physical view. These implementations or goes on, and finally the software system develops a database management system. How is it possible? Let's see. Now we will see some of the steps involved in the database design. So the requirement analysis, conceptual design, logical design, schema refinement, physical data design, data turning, and security design. So requirement analysis is nothing but gathering of data. So what data has to be stored and how data has to be stored and what are its maximal conditions that any requirement it has. All of these kind of things will be checked in this data analysis step. And conceptual design is nothing but a representation of the ER model. ER model, in the sense, it represents a relations and it represents the entities which are related in that database. And logical design defines any relationship between these entities, and schema refinement makes normalization techniques and makes this database more consistent as well as efficient. And physical database design has index and clusters. These physical database design has index values, as we have already discussed in the concept of data structures like linked list. On the basis of these index values, they can be stored easily. And data turning means, is there any redundancy? They can be overcome by this data turning step. And security design, in this sense, authorization is given to certain users who are eligible for that data manipulation. And here we can also go through some of the examples so that we can define this database design easily. Here we have three relations or three tables. Okay, first one is users table, then is products, then orders table. In users table, we have attributes like user ID, first name, last name, address, email. And the products, we have product ID, product name, product description, and price. And orders, we have in the orders table, we have order ID, user ID, product ID, total paid. How all of these tables are related through a database design, we can see now. Here, user table, as we can see in the user table, we have user ID and all of these attributes, and the products table, we have product ID and all of these attributes. Here, these two tables are connected to this orders table in the form of uniquely identifying keys. Here in users table, user ID is the uniquely identifying key and product ID is the uniquely identifying key in the product table. So these uniquely identified keys are nothing but the four primary keys. These primary keys are used in the other table, in the form of a foreign key. Here in orders table, order ID is the primary key, whereas user ID and product ID are taken from these two tables as the foreign keys in this orders table. And another attribute like total paid has been added. Here, as we can see, foreign key is represented with brown line and primary key is represented with green line and connection is represented with red line. So here user ID, product ID and order ID are primary keys, whereas user ID and product ID in the orders table are the foreign keys. This is all about database design. By these physical representations only we can design our database, and in further sessions we will go through some more topics in our database design. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. It motivated me to do more videos, and thank you.